Hello, everybody. This is Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar. And what I want to talk about is dump divert loads for wind turbines. What are they? What are they for? What do they do? And what applications do you use a divert load for? Well, in front of me, I have several different types of divert loads, dump loads for wind turbines, and that's what they're made for. Anyway, this is an example of the type of divert dump loads that we have here at the store. Some are enclosed in a nice steel box, some are just wire caged, and others are loose. We just sell loose ones. We even have water heating elements that can be used as divert loads. This is a DC water heating element that can be used for a dump load or divert load. Now, we make several dump loads, divert loads. As you notice, ours has a wire cage over it, which keeps anything from touching the resistors. They can get very hot. And then you'll notice the metal plate, and it has standoffs. It is simply screwed to a wall and is perfectly safe. The heat is directed away from the wall by use of that back plate. Now, for you, those of you that want something a little bit nicer unit enclosed in a nice heavy steel box, we also have these dump divert loads. All of these divert loads are made for 12, 24, or 48 volt wind turbines. You cannot hook up a 48 volt wind turbine to a 12 volt dump load. What does a dump load actually do? Well, you have a wind turbine and it's charging a battery bank, and the battery bank is full. The wind turbine is connected through a charge controller, and at which point the charge controller will disconnect the wind turbine. But you don't want your wind turbine just freewheeling. Say it's running at 2000 RPM or 1000 RPM, all of a sudden the battery bank is full and the charge controller disconnects. What would happen is the wind turbine could rev right up to 2,000 RPMs. Now, when it goes back into connect mode, it will slam that turbine down real hard, slow it down real fast, and throw a big voltage spike into your battery bank or charge controller. You don't want that to happen. So what happens is, you take, like our charge controllers, have divert modes on them. When the battery bank is full, the wind turbine will divert over to these bank of resistors, and it will keep the wind turbine under a nice steady load. It won't let it rev up at all. When it clicks back over to charging, it'll just go back to the battery bank and start charging once again. So you never want to let your wind turbine freewheel. It's not a good idea. I mean, you can, but you don't want to do it. If you have a 12 volt wind turbine, you need a 12 volt dump load or divert load. 24 volt, you need 24 volt, and 48 volt. You need a 48 volt wind turbine to be matched up with a 48 volt dump load. Okay, say you've got a 500 watt wind turbine, you'd want like a 600 watt divert load. You want your divert load a little bit bigger than your wind turbine. Now these resistors can get, say you got a windstorm going on, and your wind turbine is diverting constantly. These resistors can get very hot. I mean, really hot to where they burn your finger. That's the idea for these cages and these standoff plates. Now, as you'll notice on our divert loads that we build, it's a nice metal plate, screwed to the wall just like so. There's some screw holes right there. You just simply screw it to a wall, whatever you got. It's going to stand off the wall. It doesn't matter how hot these things get. It's never going to affect your wall whatsoever. Now, here's a problem. A lot of people sell these resistors, and we also sell resistors if you want to build your own dump loads. But what you never do is take this dump load, this resistor, and screw it just the way you see it here against a piece of plywood or against a wall. Not a good idea. These things can get very hot. I mean, hot enough. I mean, you can see the heat is going to be transferred. If you've got a plywood wall, the heat's going to be transferred right to that plywood. And I have seen in a windstorm that just was endless, these resistors getting almost red hot. And there's no way you'd want to mount one of these right to the wall. You shouldn't put it on a metal plate. It doesn't really matter what it is, just a metal plate that's between, that stands up like this, with little legs. So there actually is one company out there that has these resistors mounted in a cage. It's a nice perforated metal cage. The problem is, the cage is here, and the resistors are facing the wall. That is a bad idea. Could it catch fire? I don't know. It's possible it could, but even with that possible in mind, I would never want to do that. Never have one of these resistors just facing a wall, especially an old wood wall. You don't have to dump your wind turbine, we'll say, over to a set of resistors. These resistors do put off heat, and if it's in a small room, yeah, it'll actually heat the room up. But you can dump your load over to a DC water heating element. We've got all kinds of these adjustable thermostats and just stock ones. These will fit a standard water heater. When the load is diverted, you can heat hot water with it. Anyway, I hope that explains dump divert loads for you. And I'm Jeff at Missouri Wind and Solar. Thanks for watching.